Hello investors, welcome back to your number one place for all your investing needs. So today we're going to be discussing the top five stocks that have earnings coming up this week, and these could potentially have some great buying opportunities for us in the long run. And this is something that we're going to be taking a look at. Now before we get into the list guys, can we smash that like button? Let's try to get over 200 plus likes on this video. It helps the channel grow obviously. And also guys, if you want more content like this, go ahead and press that subscribe button and turn on that bell notification so you get notified every time I make a new video. I make videos on penny stocks, blue chip stocks, dividend stocks, and just overall investing in the stock market. So if you're interested in that, go ahead and click that subscribe and let's get into the list. So the number five stock that has earnings this week is going to be ticker symbol NVDA, which is Nvidia. So Nvidia is an American multinational technology company. It designs graphics processing units for the gaming and professional markets, as well as system on a chip units for mobile computing and automotive market. So Nvidia is actually pretty huge. I mean, look at here. When the market crashed, Nvidia did not budge. It was trading at $205, and it continued to trend up. So it's went up over 100% just since March. Currently trading at $462.56, and it also has many things coming up like this right here, where I'm going to show you Nvidia hosting GeForce event on September 1st. So this is going to be huge. So we have earnings this week, and then on September 1st we have this event, and everybody is expecting that they're going to do something big. So the thing is, there's rumors that have suggested Nvidia will launch RTX 30 series graphic cards. So that is something that people are waiting for our announcement. That's going to happen on the 1st of September. At least that's what people are predicting. So that is kind of it might push the stock up a little bit depending on what type of news comes out during that event. But also these earnings are going to be pretty extreme. People are expecting this to be one of the best earnings seasons that they've ever had, best quarters ever in the history. So that's something we're going to have to keep an eye out on this week. I believe the earnings are either Wednesday or Thursday. But let's take a look right here. They have a dividend, actually. They have a dividend rate. Wow, 64 cents per share. Their yield is 0.14%. Very little dividend, but hey, at least they have some type of dividend starting up. Their market cap is about 284.54 billion. So that is a wow. That is a pretty nice market cap if we take a look right there. And then their earnings. So something we just talked about. Obviously, they had earnings in May 21st, 2020. The EPS actual was $1.80, and the surprise was beat by 12 cents. Their revenue was 3.08 billion, which was a beat by 82.13 million. That's amazing. And then earnings are on the 19th, so that is actually Wednesday post market. EPS estimate is going to be around $1.97. Their revenue estimate is 3.66 billion, which is higher than the previous quarter, like we just said. Dividend, just to make a quick glance. I mean, obviously we know it's nothing. 16 cents dividend yield right here. It's nothing extreme. Like we just said, they're just getting started with this dividend. 4-year average yield 0.34%. Dividend growth right here, 7 years of growth. It's very little, obviously, 64 cents per share. But obviously, with the price going up, that's why it's so low. But it's 16 cents quarterly, and then their payout ratio right here, 7.85%, super low. Something we like to see. But Nvidia earnings, we're expecting earnings to be very good. We have this event coming up on the September 1st, so those are definitely things to keep an eye out on, guys. And I would suggest looking at it. All right, guys, so the number four pick for this week is going to be ticker symbol TGT, which is Target. So this is an American retail corporation. It is actually the eighth largest retailer in the United States. Currently, Target is trading at $136.53. When the crash happened, it pulled back down to about $90, $92 per share. It's had this trend up, and it's been trading kind of sideways here. If we take a look between that in that $120 range for actually since what? Here it was May, beginning of May, all the way until about almost the beginning of August. So in the past few days, actually, few weeks, it's been going up about $16, which is actually a pretty nice uptrend. So about 10% gain in the past 2 weeks. Target, obviously, everybody's going to Target and buying things as they're open. If we look right here, the dividend rate is $2.72 per share. Their yield is about almost 2%. With a market cap of 68.27 billion. If we take a quick look right here for the earnings, actually, what happened last time and what's predicted for this time, announcement date was on May 20th, 2020. The EPS actual was 59 cents per share, beat by 19 cents. Their revenue was 19.61 billion, which was a beat by 576.64 million. And their next announcement is going to be obviously August 19th, which is Wednesday. And their EPS estimate is $1.64 per share, which is almost triple what it was last quarter. And their revenue estimate is $20.07 billion, which is about half a billion more than what they had last quarter. If we take a quick look at the dividend, it's about 68 cents per share, which we mentioned. Their 4-year average yield is about 3.38%, which is not bad at all. And then years of growth, they've been growing for 52 years. So that is actually a very, very nice dividend. I did not know the target has been, around for that long with their dividends. So 52 years of growth, which is amazing. Currently about $2.60 per share. And their dividend history right here. Obviously, it's a quarterly paying dividend, about 68 cents per quarter. And then right here, payout ratio 52.85%. So Target, definitely another one, as people are going to the stores just like Walmart, Home Depot, Lowe's. Target is another big one that people are definitely moving to, and I think that they're going to be having some great opportunities until this whole thing ends. Now, before we go ahead and get into this third pick, like I said, go ahead and smash that like button. Let's try to get over 200 likes on this video. It helps the channel, it helps everything grow, and I'd really appreciate it. If you guys enjoyed this video so far, click that subscribe button and that notification bell so you can get updated every time I make a new video. But the number three pick is going to be ticker symbol DE, which is the Deere and Company, which is John Deere. So John Deere currently trading at $191.13. This is an American corporation that manufactures agricultural, construction, and forestry machinery, drivetrains used in heavy equipment, and lawn care equipment, obviously. So this stock is actually really good, and it's actually unique. You guys don't see me kind of pick these type of stocks that are kind of like unknown. People don't really trade this stock, but this stock is actually beautiful. It was trading down here about $110 at the low when the Rona started, and it's been trending up obviously here. It's had nice, I mean, look at this nice in the past month and a half. It's went from 153 to 191. That's about a $40 gain. That's nice, in my opinion. They also have a dividend rate. It's $3.04 per share. The yield is 1.59% with a market cap of 59.8 billion. So almost as big as Target right there, actually, if you're paying attention. And right here, if we take a look for the earnings, what they're expecting and what they had last quarter. So the announcement date was on May 22nd, 2020. EPS actual was $2.11 per share. They beat by 49 cents. Revenue actual was 8.22 billion, beat by 544.73 million. So amazing beat right there again. And then we have this week we have earnings. I don't know why here it says 11:25 because earnings are this week, and earnings they're everybody's expecting to have some decent earnings, and especially myself, I'm expecting some decent earnings as well from them. I think that they're going to be doing very, very well. And right here, let's take a look real quick at their dividend. So their dividend is 76 cents per share. And then right here for their 4-year average yield, it's about almost 2% average yield. Their dividend growth right here, they have years of growth, 3 years. So they've had a decent dividend but I guess they had a little bit of a dip. But in the past 3 years, they've had growth, and it's about $3.04, like we said. Their dividend history, it's a quarterly paying dividend about 76 cents. And then their dividend safety payout ratio is 49%. So not too bad. At least it's under the 50%. But John Deere, definitely another stock that I would be taking a look at, especially with earnings coming up. And a lot of people are changing and shifting gears into these things to do things that, on their own at home. And they're buying equipment and other things that could benefit this stock. Coming in at number two, it's a stock that we're all very, very familiar with. It's going to be ticker symbol WMT, which is Walmart. So obviously, Walmart is an American multinational retail corporation that operates a chain of hypermarkets, discount department stores, and grocery stores. So we all know one of the big things with Walmart is going to be Walmart Plus. Everybody's expecting that to be huge and a big competitor kind of with Amazon, which, I mean, I don't know. I think that Amazon is definitely going to be number one overall, and that nobody can compete with them ever, at least for now, because they're just so big. It would take a lot for a company to try to compete with them, obviously. But Walmart's doing, pretty decent. It was down here at a low of about, let's see, $100 maybe per share, $104 per share when the crash happened. The stock made a high right here about $132, $133. We made a slow pullback down to about 119, 117, and then once they announced Walmart Plus, the stock jumped up here to about $132, and it's been trading at that price. Now, one thing to know, obviously, with Walmart is the stock is not a stock that's going to shoot up huge amounts for no reason. I mean, you can see here for years and years, the stock just kind of trades at the same price for a while. But the good thing about it is it has a dividend, and as a dividend investor, you know, this is a good stock. But now, potentially with some growth, you know, there's some growth with this Walmart plus the Rona. A lot of people are going to Walmart, so I feel like Walmart has a potential to kind of grow a little bit in the next, you know, year or two, or however long it takes us to get over this. If we look right here, dividend rate $2.16 per share. Their yield is 1.63%. Their market cap is $375.52 billion. Very, very big company. One of the biggest companies, you know, out there that we have. If we look for the earnings right here, you know, announcement date was on May 19, 2020. EPS actual was $1.18, beat by 9 cents. And then their revenue was $133.67 billion, beat by $2.76 billion. Once again, I don't know why, you know, they mess up this. The website is kind of messed up, and it doesn't show that the you know, earnings are coming up this week, but earnings are definitely this week, and you know, they're hoping to have earnings definitely beat, you know, what they had last quarter. So Walmart, definitely another one that we want to keep an eye out on right there. But let's take a quick look for their dividend to see how that's doing. So 54 cents per share for their yield. The 4-year average yield is 2.3%, which is, you know, a decent percent. Years of growth, 47 years. So Walmart's been around for a long time, and it's been consistently growing their dividends. So even in tough times, you know, they're growing that dividend to be about $2.16 per share. Their dividend history right here, it's a quarterly paying dividend, obviously, and it's about 54 cents per share. And then their dividend safety payout ratio, 42%. Walmart is definitely a stock that I have in my portfolio, and it's a stock that I plan on holding for the long run. And just because it has this nice little dividend, actually, that it kind of makes the stock even more attractive for me, especially right now, during the Rona and all this stuff that's going on with, you know, the world. I think that Walmart is a great buy. Coming in at number one, we have ticker symbol BJ, which is BJ's Wholesale Club Holdings. So this is going to be an American membership only warehouse club chain. So obviously, if you guys have never been to BJ's, basically it's a store that you go and people pretty much buy things in bulk for cheaper, because the more you buy, the cheaper it is, obviously. So you're going to be buying, you know, instead of buying maybe like 10 Cokes, you're going to be buying like 20 Cokes or something like that. And it's going to be all packaged up, and that's what you get. Or like, you know, chips or whatever. So BJ's definitely another stock that is definitely benefiting right now, because people are going out hoarding and buying a lot, and especially with the stimulus, you know, package that everybody got, all the money that everybody's getting, unemployment, people have more money now, so people are going out and just buying things in bulk, you know, which they weren't able to do in the past. So BJ's is trading at $41.48. You know, when the Rona started, it was trading around $19, so it's had over 100% gain. So we've had over 100% gain. They do not currently have a dividend or anything like that, but they have a market cap of $5.75 billion. So it's actually a pretty small company. It's not like the biggest company right now. It's nowhere compared to Target or Walmart. But this one, announcement date was on May 21st, 2020. EPS actual was 69 cents per share, beat by 32 cents. Their revenue was 3.8 billion, beat by 472.59 million. So almost half a billion right there, beat. That is amazing. Next earnings announcement date is going to be August 20th, 2020, pre-market. EPS estimate is 59 cents per share. Revenue estimate is 3.74 billion. So about the same as, you know, previous quarter. I think that that's definitely going to beat, in my opinion. But I think that BJ's, as long as the Rona is around, and especially if we get another stimulus package going on, you know, once Congress and all the members in the House go back in September, if we can agree on a, you know, on a package and more people get more money, I think that this stock is definitely going to be benefiting from that. And a lot of other retailer stocks and, you know, shopping stores are going to be definitely benefiting, because people are going to be going out and spending that stimulus package or their money that they're receiving from unemployment, or just things like that in general. But I think that all of these stocks are definitely great, you know, stocks to at least look at to see what's going on and do your own research on. Well, guys, like we said, those are our five picks for this week. They have earnings coming up this week, so a lot of these have very huge potential, and we're going to be seeing how the company has been doing during this Rona. And a lot of these companies are going to have some of the best earnings, you know, ever quarters that they've ever had in their history. But obviously, before investing into any of these stocks, you know, like I always say, I'm not a financial advisor. So make sure you do your own research before investing into any type of stocks in the market. You know, paper trade on thinkorswim or something like that, where so you can get to learn, do your own research, you know, get on Google or talk to a financial advisor or somebody that's actually, you know, doing this for their job. And yeah, just make sure you know what you're doing before you invest into stocks. I think that these are great buying opportunity, but just for entertainment purposes, in my opinion. I think that, you know, since the Rona is around, that a lot of these companies are going to be benefiting from it, because people are be going out and spending a lot of money. And that's why I have these on my watch list, obviously, to see what happens in this earnings season. Now, if you guys enjoyed this video, go ahead and smash that like button. I'd really appreciate it. Leave a comment below. Do you own any of these stocks, or are you buying any of these stocks? Make sure you subscribe to the channel, turn on that bell notification for more updates like this, and I hope I see you guys next time. Goodbye.